choice.
That I ain't going.
Going
I ain't blowing no smoke. I mean, I've been sober, but you should have known it. I wasn't going.
Alexa, stop. Hey, what's up, you guys? And welcome back to my channel. Do you know what I'm going to do? What I'm actually doing right now? I'm going through every little kink video that I did when I was younger and redoing them. Because a lot has changed and needs to be updated. So I'm going to keep these videos up so you can have a look at those. But we shall be updating them. So today's video is FinDom. If you watch my other videos, you know what FinDom is at this point. But I'm gonna go about this video as if you didn't know what FinDom was. FinDom stands for, it's literally in the name, it stands for financial domination. So we're gonna be talking about for the kinky bitches out there. I literally wrote notes as well. So like I kept on track, I didn't have my usual ADHD rants. So FinDom, I'm gonna start with the basis. FinDom is literally financial domination, is where, as usual in the BDSM kinky world, you've got a dom and a sub. Traditionally in FinDom, the dom is a female, which go by goddess. But now it's so modernized now, so you can get male doms, which I guess includes gay men, because obviously then they can't participate in FinDom if all the dominants are female. So yeah, you traditionally have a female dominant, which goes by goddess. It is very, there's not much leeway with it. It's very like strict in the sense of like, you have to have respect for your goddess. They're taking all your money. And basically FinDom is just like the sub, sometimes referred as pay pig, piggy bank, pay pig, gives money to the goddess just for existing, basically. Like as a, kind of like, think of it as like, you're a woman, like you're worthy of so much more. And like the man's kind of like, I'm nothing. And I'm just gonna give you money because you exist and you deserve it, kind of thing. And you can also have debt contracts in FinDom. Which technically, it's like, you know when you loan money from the bank and then you have to like pay it back in like installments, or like you have a contract, a payment plan. It's like that, you have a payment plan if you're dom. You got to pay the money, otherwise the consequences, which links in to the like blackmail aspect of it. We kind of like, this kind of falls into the category where with men that do FinDom and have like a goddess, a dom, but are married, which I've never partaken in, because I don't mess with married men. I don't want like married men. I do not want that karma. And to me, it's just icky. But yeah, so if your sub has a partner, they tend to want to partake in blackmail during scene time, play time. Being in a scene is basically like when you conform into your role of dom and sub, so that you can basically not have to be in your dom and sub roles when you're out of scene. So like during scene play, like scene time, blackmail. So the dom has literally all of their subs, like contacts, like how to contact their wife, workplaces, so and so. So obviously the blackmail is blackmail. So it runs smoothly. So there's like, if you don't pay this and this and this and that, I'm gonna contact your wife and tell her that you're doing this dirty little thing. It's not dirty, but it's kind of like, do you know what I mean? Like you'd say things just to get the ball rolling. And degradation is a real big part of FinDom as well. Like, not obviously every sub is different and not every sub likes being degraded, but degradation is a big part of FinDom. Just basically, dom basically just says like, you're nothing, like you're just a man, like you have a small penis, da 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 da. Basically just being a bitch. But the men actually really enjoy it. They enjoy it to the tea. And you know what? Necessarily, it's normally men that aren't necessarily submissive in their day-to-day life. Like, they have office jobs and whatever. And they tend to be very dominant in their family and stuff. That fall into these categories. Where they just want to be nothing. Like, you can literally be like, you're fucking going my shoe, you're dead, you're disgusting. Like, I could wipe my ass with you kind of thing. And they were like, oh my gosh, yes. Take my money kind of thing. And you can make a lot of money off of FinDom. A lot of money. Like, I used to do FinDom. Because I don't know, it just intrigued me. But I don't do it anymore. But it used to intrigue me. I used to make a buck. In England, so a pound. Money. But I don't know, I can't like recommend places for you guys to like, if you are interested in it, and I say only generally interested in it because it takes a lot out of you, and if you're just doing it for money, then it's just not it. I can't recommend any places because it's so heavily saturated by like scammers nowadays. Like, it used to be Twitter used to be a gold mine for doing FinDom, and it doesn't even have to be just money. Like, people can, you can have an Amazon wish list, and people can buy you stuff and send you stuff. And sometimes they like to be anonymous, sometimes they don't. But yeah, like, there's just so many ways to do FinDom. You can have them come over to your house and do chores and clean up on their hands and knees. You can have them come to your house and give you money face to face on their knees, the money in their mouth kind of thing. But yeah, I don't really have a place to tell you where to go for FinDom because I feel like it's all scary. Like, I tried FetLife, but FetLife is so heavily guarded with reason. I think there's a lot of websites, but they're very heavily guarded with reason, and it's kind of hard to maneuver the platforms. Like, FetLife I've tried, but bro, the things I've seen in there, like, I don't really want to see. So I've like, I just basically fell out the FinDom thing, even though I really enjoyed it. You got FetLife, what else do you have? Reddit, but Reddit also, like, you know when you like make a Reddit account and you have to wait how many days and whether to get verified, whatever. And I tried to join a Reddit community for FinDom, but you can't even post anything on there. So like, how are you supposed to reach out to other subs, whatever? Not reach out, but like advertise your services. Because a goddess should not reach out to a sub, a sub should reach out to a goddess. It's a whole pill thing. Like, you're not gonna want to beg a sub to give you money because the begging is their part, kind of thing. There's Discord, you can Discord, but it's really hard to find communities on there. I don't know, I feel like if you really want to get into FinDom, you're gonna have to just basically put yourself out there, like create a whole profile, like, and you have to publicly like show your face and stuff. A lot of TikTokers, like actually like well-known TikTokers, do FinDom. Like, once in a while I go on the FinDom on Twitter, and I see a lot of like TikTok celebrities on there doing their thing. I feel like it's easier to do FinDom when you show your face. I don't show my face because no one needs to see my fucking face. Do you know what I mean? And it's not like a thing. It's not like when you do OnlyFans where you have to like show your titties and your badge and your ass and your asshole and everything in between. Like, you can, it's a good way to participate in a fetish or a kink. I forgot which one's which. I did a whole video on it, but I forgot which one's which. Without having to like show your face and anonymity. There you go. It's hard to say. Yeah, like it's a really, like, if you're into it, I'm telling you now, if you're not into it, it doesn't intrigue you, it's gonna be a really hard thing to do and you're gonna be drained and it's just not worth it. It's not worth it for you, and it's not worth the sub that you might take on because they're really into it and you're just wasting their time. You're wasting your own time. But it's good money if you're into it. Instagram. I heard Instagram's a really big platform to advertise your Dom services. But you have to show your face, obviously, and you have to like really take care of your account. But yeah, it's just really, really hard to find subs nowadays that are into FinDom. Because everyone's scared to get scammed nowadays. Like, you literally be like, oh, like, I want to see your face. Scared to get scammed, da, 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 da. I'm not sure if I see anyone. Like, you guys know, whoever's watching knows I liked to partake in FinDom. I don't do it anymore. But yeah, it's just, it's, you'll find some weird ones on there as well. It's like, there's a lot of, how do I say this without sounding disgusting. There's a lot of bodily fluid play, which I refuse to partake in. Like, as a dom, I feel like you should have really hard set rules. Like, I won't participate in bodily fluid play. I'm not gonna video call you. I'm not gonna talk to you on the phone. I'm not gonna Snapchat call you. I don't do any of that stuff. And this is such a different tune now than, like, when did I start this? I think I was 16. I'm 22 now. When I started this at 16, I was like, oh, like, I'm a sub. I'm definitely a sub. I'm definitely a switch now, leaning more towards dom. Very much so. So, like, it's a completely different tune. So, I feel like, and please, I swear to God, please do not do this if you're underage, because not only are you going to get yourself in trouble and traumatise yourself, you can get the other person in trouble and it's just not worth it. But you will traumatise out of yourself. I shouldn't have started it when I started it, but I did. I've seen some weird things. But yeah, it's a heavy one. I feel like BDSM is very, very heavy. And it's, in my head, it's so normalised. And I'm like, oh my gosh, everyone does this. Like, everyone's into, like, kinky stuff. No, it's a lot of vanilla people out there. And the people that wouldn't even venture into the things that I would like to venture in on, or what I've ventured into. I feel like I've gone off topic now. See, this is why I had notes, guys. Because I ventured off the topic. I can't read my mind. Oh, yes. Tributes are very, very, very important as the dom, and you should never, like, make exceptions. Tributes are basically just thank yous from subs, but they're thank yous before you even start a session, or before they even said anything to you. So, of course, you can make up the prices you want, but I used to go for, like, 25 to 30 pounds tribute, kind of like a, let's say, like, a deposit that they can't get back, basically, to talk to you and see if you're compatible as a dom sub partnership kind of thing. And when I say dom sub, like, you don't have to have a permanent sub. You don't have to be someone's permanent dom. It can just be like a one-time session, which I tend to prefer when it comes to, like, earning money online via subs kind of thing. Just because it's just, subs tend to get very clingy, but I think it's because when they're in their subspace. The subspace is when your submissive is in a submissive head mindset. Yeah. And keep in mind that if you are doing FinDom online and online only, you still have to provide aftercare for your subs. Aftercare is very important because a lot of people can feel like shit after they've done the scene. Traditionally, you'd have a sub in person, and in person you give them water, cuddles, make sure they have a warm bath, whatever, make sure they feel okay and take care of, especially if you had a hard, long session. But online, I'd recommend checking if they're okay. Just like, oh, like, how are you feeling about the session? Are you okay? Da, 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 da. What did you like? What didn't you like? So and so, like, just make sure, because that will keep yourself coming back to you, basically. But yeah, I don't think I have anything else to say about FinDom. FinDom, financial domination. They give you money, and you can literally live off doing FinDom. Like, it is cash, and I'm saying money. Like, you can literally get £250 off a session, like one session, and it'll take you like not even half an hour. Do you know what I mean? But yeah, I would recommend FinDom if you're into that shit. Thank you so much for watching. I've got my Instagram link down below, Babeinpinksilk. My TikTok, Babeinpinksilk. What else do I have? That's it. TikTok and Instagram. And let me know what you'd like to watch next. Bye.